Study of science. So today I'm back with another video discussing on an important topic. So let's start our session today. So in today's session we are going to understand about the allotropes of carbon. So before understanding the various allotropes of carbon, let us understand what are allotropes. When we talk about allotropes, they are the compounds which are made up of the same type of elements but they have the different structures. I repeat, the allotropes are the compounds which are made up of same type of elements but they have different structure. How do they have different structure? You may have a confusion. Ma'am is telling it is made up of same type of element. They are having the different structure. Then how do they have the different structures? I just give an example for it. See, if you look at the diamond and graphite. See, they are the allotropes of carbon. They are made up of the carbon element. Even though they are made up of same type of element, their structure, their physical appearance is different. Correct? So that is what the allotrope is all about. So in this session, we are going to mainly focus on three types of the allotropes. That is the diamond, graphite and the Buckminster fullerene. So these are the three important allotropes of carbon which we are going to study in this session. So as I also told you that they appear in different states, their properties are also different. Allotropes, they're made up of same type of element, but their appearance is different. As their appearance is different, the arrangement of atom inside them also different. As a result of that, their properties also different. Clear? So, as I told you, the diamond, graphite and Buckminster fullerene are the three important allotropes which we are going to focus in this session. So those three, they fall under the category of the crystalline form of carbon. There is also another form of carbon which is called as the amorphous form of carbon. So when we talk about the amorphous form, the examples for those are the coal, charcoal, lamp black and soot. So these are the examples for the amorphous form of carbon and they exist in the powder nature. They exist in the powder nature. And also they have been obtained from the crystalline form of carbon only. That is the reason that we are going to focus mainly on the crystalline form of carbon instead amorphous form of carbon. So now, let us start discussing on each type of carbon, their arrangement of atoms and their conductivity also. So we'll start with the diamond. So when I talk about the diamond, let us first talk about the arrangement of atoms in the diamond. You know that the diamond is made up of carbon, right? And what is the atomic number of carbon? It is 6. And what about its valency? It is 4. The valency of carbon is 4. And as carbon is having the valency 4, it can bond with 4 other carbon atoms. Correct. So here in the diamond, each carbon atom, they are bonded to other 4 carbon atoms. They are bonded to other 4 carbon atoms. As a result of this, they have a rigid structure. They are very hard. And you all know that the diamond is the hardest substance ever known. It is the hardest substance ever known. Clear? So when I talk about the conductivity, diamond is the bad conductor or it is a poor conductor of electricity. It does not conduct the electricity. Clear? Because in the initial, when I start the lessons only, I have told you that most of the carbon compounds, they are the poor conductors of electricity except the graphite. Except the graphite. Correct? So, as we are discussing about the diamond, diamond is the poor conductor of electricity. And here, you can see how the carbon atoms, each carbon atom is bonded to 4 other carbon atoms. So, as a result of this kind of formation, they have a rigid structure. Clear? So now let us focus towards the graphite. So when I talk about the graphite, so let us move towards the graphite. So let us now talk about the arrangement of atoms in the graphite. When we talk about the arrangement of atoms in the graphite, you know, again the carbon can combine with four other atoms of carbon, but in the graphite each carbon atom is bonded with the three other carbon atoms and the fourth side is free. The fourth side is free in the graphite. As a result of this, they do not have the rigid structure, they are soft in nature and they are also can easily be breakable. Right? Why they are soft? Because here the carbons, the arrangement of carbon inside, they do not have the rigidity. As a result of this, they are soft in nature. If you look at here, how the carbon, each carbon atom is bonded with other three carbon atoms. You can look at this. And as a result of this kind of formation, they form a hexagonal array. Then when I talk about the conductivity, by now you all know that the graphite is the good conductor of electricity. It can conduct the electricity. Clear? So now let us focus towards the last type of the allotrope, that is the Buckminster fullerene. When we talk about the Buckminster fullerene, it was been discovered by one of the US scientists by the name Buckminster Fuller. As a result of this, this allotrope got the name Buckminster fullerene. And the first allotrope of Buckminster was found to be C60. It was the C60 which was found. The first form of the allotrope of Buckminster fullerene was C60, where 60 carbon atoms were arranged in the structure of football. They were arranged in the structure of football, or it was the geoid dome. It was the geoid dome. So this is what the structure which was found for the first time. That was the Buckminster fullerene. For the Buckminster fullerene. Clear? So that is what we wanted to learn in this session. We wanted to learn about the, what is that, allotropes of carbon. We have learned about the definition of allotrope. We have also learned about the three important allotropes of carbon, that is the diamond, graphite and the Buckminster fullerene. We have also learned about the arrangement of atoms. See, we have seen the arrangement of atom in the case of diamond, that each carbon atom, look at here, it is bonded to four other carbon atoms. What about the graphite? Each carbon atom, it is bonded to three other carbon atoms. Correct? So when I look at the Buckminster fullerene, it was like a geoid dome, or it was having football structure. Correct? So we have found a difference in the arrangement of atom in the same compound, it is in the allotropes. Correct? Even though the element is same, in three cases also, their arrangement of atoms are different. As a result of that, the structure also differs and their properties are also differs. Hope you all have cleared with whatever I have taught you in this session. If you like this session, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. For more videos, log on to YouTube and search for Source Study of Science. Thank you.